Welcome to the online lecture series of Turbo Machines. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is lecture on Impact of Jet Part 9, that is series of moving curved plates. This is acknowledgement to the authors and internet resource for being used the concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain expression for force exerted by jet striking to series of moving curved plates. You will also be able to show that jet striking to series of curved plates mounted on wheel gives maximum efficiency 100%. Let us see impact of jet on series of moving curved plate. So here we can see, in this case the curved plates are fixed on the wheel which is moving with velocity u in the direction of jet. So as one plate comes out of the jet strikes to the other plate. So in this case, mass flow rate of the jet is taken as m dot is equal to rho into A into V in kg per second, where rho is density of water in kg per meter cube, A area of jet, that is pi by 4 into d square, where d is the diameter of jet, V is the velocity of jet, u is the plate velocity. Now the difference between jet velocity and plate velocity, that is V minus U, it is called as effective velocity or relative velocity. Theta is a angle made by the tangential component of jet at the outlet. So that we will see in the next slide. So we can see a diagram. Here this is a tangential component of the velocity at outlet, that is V minus U. Now in this case, it is making angle theta with the horizontal. So its horizontal component will be what? V minus U cos theta. Now force exerted by jet on the series of curved plate can be obtained by using impulse momentum principle. So F is equal to m dot into velocity difference. So in this case, force in the direction of x, that is Fx, is equal to m dot, that is rho AV bracket. Now velocity before striking, that is relative velocity, means V minus U, minus velocity after striking, means this component, but its direction is opposite, that's why with minus sign, V minus U cos theta. So minus minus comes plus. Again V minus U is here same, that's why we can take this term as a common. So we get formula for Fx, that is equal to rho AV bracket V minus U, another bracket 1 plus cos theta in Newton. Now work done per second means power, that is product of force and plate velocity. So putting the expression for force, here we get work done per second equal to rho AV bracket V minus U, another bracket 1 plus cos theta into plate velocity U, and power is in Watt. Efficiency, we know that it is ratio of work done per second to kinetic energy per second, where kinetic energy of jet per second is half m dot V square, where m dot is mass flow rate, that is rho AV. So here kinetic energy of jet per second is what? Half rho A V into V square. Further it can be written as half rho A V cube. But for the calculation we use this term. So let us put work done formula and kinetic energy formula in the efficiency. So here efficiency is equal to rho A V bracket V minus U, another bracket 1 plus cos theta into U, divided by half rho a v into v square. Now, if we observe rho a v at the numerator and denominator are common, can be cancelled, we get efficiency is equal to 2u bracket v minus u, that is relative velocity, another bracket 1 plus cos theta divided by v square. Now, the derivation for maximum efficiency. Now, for finding out maximum efficiency, we take jet velocity constant, means there is variable as plate velocity. So, we can have the condition, that is differentiation with respect to differentiation of efficiency with respect to plate velocity, means d by du of efficiency is equal to 0. So d by du of efficiency expression we can write here, that is 2u bracket v minus u, another bracket 1 plus cos theta divided by v square bracket complete is equal to 0. Now in this case, 2 by v square and 1 plus cos theta, these terms are constant, so will be outside of the differentiation. So remaining is u into v minus u square bracket complete is equal to 0. Now as the constant terms cannot be equal to 0, means d by du of bracket uv minus u square is equal to 0. Now derivative with respect to u, keeping velocity constant, so v is a constant and derivative of u will be 1. And derivative of u square will be 2u. So v minus 2u is equal to 0, means v is equal to 2u. So now v is equal to 2u, we can put in the maximum efficiency formula, which is 2u bracket v minus u, another bracket 1 plus cos theta upon v square. So 2u bracket at the place of v 2u minus this u, another bracket 1 plus cos theta divided by this v is what, 2u, and its square. Now this 2u multiplied by here 2u minus u, that is u, means 2u into u, that is 2u square, another bracket 1 plus cos theta divided by square of 2u, that is 4u square. Now in this case we can see numerator and denominator u square, so we can cancel u square, so what remains, 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. So formula for maximum efficiency is what, 1 plus cos theta divided by 2, but provided condition is what, u is equal to v by 2, means we can write that condition for maximum efficiency of jet striking the series of curved plate is the velocity of plate is half of the jet velocity. Now for semicircular vane, means when theta is equal to 0, maximum efficiency formula will be what, 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. Here theta is 0, so cos 0 is 1. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, 2 by 2 is 1, means in percentage 100, means in case of series of curved plate mounted on wheel, which gives maximum efficiency 100%. So after this session, now you can illustrate expression for force exerted by jet striking two series of curved plates. You can also show that jet striking two series of curved plates mounted on the wheel gives maximum efficiency 100%. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.